My name's Mary McNutt. I was very sure when I was leaving the job that I'd been in that that lifestyle didn't suit me. My nature is to be entrepreneurial. My nature is not to take direction or management terribly well. I'm inclined to want to do my own thing, very independent. I have been all my life, really. And I'm not going to change now. I was getting into self-sufficiency and sort of local produce and healthy stuff and all this kind of thing. And the notion got into my head that it might be a nice thing to do to keep bees. The nature of a hive, a colony of bees, is that they want to reproduce. And they have one queen, and they have thousands of workers, and they have a few hundred drones. The drones are the male bees. And the queen's function is to be the egg layer. Okay? Now, if the queen is born, to use hatched born, if she's born during poor weather and she has to get mated within the first, say, 10 days or so of her life, okay? Now, in a nice climate, she'll go out every day. In our climate, she's lucky if she gets out once in those 10 days, you know? And the problem is she needs to mate with 20, 30 drones to get the genetic mix into her egg laying to keep the colony healthy. And also to just simply have enough fertilised eggs in her tubes. During the summer season, a healthy queen has been well mated, should be laying between 1,500 and 2,000 eggs a day. That's an awful lot of eggs, you know, so she really is an egg laying machine. Now, if she hasn't been well mated, that's going to slow up quickly and she'll just run out of fertilised eggs. And the colony is faced with the situation of, uh-oh, you know, we're not going to survive as a colony if we don't have a good, well mated queen. So they set about the whole process of deciding, okay, we have to do what the hive does. We have to split. The older bees will go away with the older queen. And the younger bees will stay, and the older queen will have laid eggs that have been selected to become new queen cells and become new queens. It's the exact same egg. It's a fertilised egg, the same as a worker egg. But what happens is they select certain... Well, they actually prepare a few cells that will be larger. And the queen lays an egg in that, and then the workers feed that egg royal jelly. Royal jelly is basically what gives you your queen, okay? They all get fed a little bit of it. Now, when you're a worker, it's called bee bread or bee food. But when you're a queen, you get a lavish amount of it. And it's royal jelly. It's the same thing exactly. Yes. But it creates a different creature. That's how it works. Yeah. Actually, that film, there was so much of it that was wrong. Yeah. As a beekeeper, you know. Like, for example, the way they portray the beekeeper coming along with the smoke. Okay. Now, I suppose from the bee's perspective, you can interpret it whatever way you like. But actually, what happens is the bees think, smoke, there must be fire. Maybe we should get ready in case we have to jump ship, okay? So they basically stuff themselves full of honey, okay? They eat all around them, and then the smoke just basically dies down and they go away. But from the beekeeper's point of view, there's two things. A, the smoke means that they're kind of busy filling themselves and they're a bit more subdued because they're kind of concerned about smoke. But the other thing is that that their bellies are so full that they can't actually bend their abdomen to sting you in the same way. So it's a mean trick. But I mean, at the end of the day, it doesn't do the bees any harm at all. It just means that they've fed themselves rather more than they normally would. And then they, you know, they get over it. So that's the use of a smoker. If you look at the bee movie, it'll be presented a very different way. The different jobs that are done in the hive by the worker bees are not assigned to specific bees for life. Each bee graduates through different jobs, okay? So the first thing they do, once they've emerged as a tiny little young bee out of the cell, is they become nurse bees and housekeeping bees, okay? So their job is to clean up the first cell, the one they came out of, okay? Then they're to go around and sort of do the housekeeping around the hive, and they look after and they feed the larvae that are developing the next generation and so on. And then gradually they move up to being guard bees, and then they become flying bees. And their job, once they're flying bees, isn't separated into pollen and nectar and propolis. They all bring all in, okay? So there aren't any propolis jocks or pollen jocks, as they say in the bee movie. Yeah, exactly. You know, they're all, and they're all female. All the workers are female, okay? So, you know, the drones are the only male bees. And basically the only difference is that they came from an unfertilized egg. So they only have one parent per se. And the workers and the potential queens, if they are deciding to produce new queens, they come from fertilized eggs. And that's the only difference between the eggs. But they all look quite different. The queen looks very different, although she's difficult to find because, you know, heaving mass of brown, furry, fuzzy stuff, you know, that's going bzzz, you know. It's hard enough to find her. The drones look quite different. They're much bigger and they've got huge eyes. That's so that they can spot the queen when they're flying. A jumper.
Is it?
Yeah, exactly, yeah. Yeah, they're extraordinary creatures. They're fabulous. They communicate with each other inside the hive, and it's not squeak, squeak, although you'll get some of that. But the flying bees that are sent out as scouts to find food will come back, and they do different dances depending on what it is they've found and where they've found it and so on. The most popular or common one is called the waggle dance. And they literally dance on the honeycomb inside the hive. This is in the dark. So how they actually figure it out, I'm not sure. But they have a very specific dance that tells the other bees what they found, how far away it is, and what direction it is. So that the other honeybees that are flying can actually go and forage from that food source. We also sell bees, and we keep bees ourselves, and we sell honey. So www.millanebeekeeping.ie if you're interested. And I'm going to take this off because I'm going to smother otherwise.